All right, folks, we got a new series picking up where we left off from Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 1. We are now doing Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2. So here we go. One thing to note beforehand, like I said at the end of the other series, I have played the first, gosh, I don't know, 30 minutes of this game 5 years ago. So the first 30 minutes, I guess you'd call it semi-blind, I don't really remember, it was some mining asteroid or something. Let's see. It is a perilous time for the galaxy. A brutal civil war has all but destroyed the Jedi Order, leaving the ailing Republic on the verge of collapse. Amid the turmoil, the evil Sith have spread across the galaxy, hunting down and destroying the remaining Jedi Knights. Narrowly escaping a deadly Sith ambush, the last known Jedi clings to life aboard a battered freighter near the ravaged world of Paragus. Yeah, that is what that was called, wasn't it? Now, the nice thing about this, in comparison to KOTOR 1, is that it should, fingers crossed, be a lot more stable than that one, as this game actually got an update, I don't know, a couple years ago or something. Because, yeah, I had the 1080 widescreen hacks all ready to go, and then it was like, oh, wait, nope, you don't need those. So I'm not gonna complain. Yeah, the reason I only played it for like 30 minutes before was because it got stuck on like some cutscene. Like we were doing something with the computer, and just the guy was just sitting there typing away, wouldn't progress past it. I let it sit there for like 30, 45 minutes, just sitting there typing. All right, so it looks like we still have the Ebonhawk. I don't know. Looks like it's seen better days.
The Ebonhawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed repairs. Your fate and that of the Ebonhawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
Well, let's continue it. Let's see what happens.
WASD to move T3M4, then turn. Press caps lock to toggle first person freeload.
Oh, goodness. That's inverted. That is inverted. We're gonna have to fix that. I do not like that. But one thing I do like is that I can do this. I could not move the camera around like that. Yeah, I don't care. Where are gameplay? Reverse mouse Y axis. There we go. Now it works correctly. That's nice that I can do that. I'm liking it already. Galaxy
This is
map.
the galaxy map. It shows you are near Paragus, a mining colony. When the hyperdrive is fixed, you can use the galaxy map to choose a destination planet.
Huh. We're gonna need a. Alright, active quest screen includes important information related to your ongoing adventures. Read this journal for hints and guidance throughout the game. Okay.
You have new quests. To view your quests, open the game menu, default, escape.
The HUD is also much larger in this one, too. I guess that's the benefits of not having to use a sketchy 1080p hacks. Laying in the med bay in critical condition, you can use a med pack to stabilize your vitals. To fully heal, memory demise will require the facilities at the Paragus mining station. All right, so I guess we gotta find ourselves a Yeah, I know how to do this game. Computer spike.
Okay. Some of which will be locked. The computer spike file you just picked up can be used to compute.
Right. Slice it. Open the main hold door. Cool. Log out. Okay. Man, this place has been trashed. Well, I don't have any computer spikes anymore. At least I don't think so. No, I do not. Okay,
Your security impossible. Scale is too low to open this footlocker.
Alright. Really? This droid is gonna bash this open. Yeah, okay. Cancel that. Low security door, how about that? Okay, cool. Body. Locker key.
This old woman appears to be dead. There is a key card on the body that looks like it opens a locker somewhere.
Yeah, how about this one right here? Oh, for God's sakes, just open it.
However, you can use your weapon to bash it open. Click on the bash icon or press 1.
Yeah, that didn't really work.
This is the main hole.
Broken droid. More parts. Alright.
If you need help exploring the Ebon Hawk, access the map screen by pressing M.
It's not
this
that big.
The
there we are. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but we're gonna try a bit of a different... Oh, there's a medpack. Bit of a different playstyle than the last one.
Medpack can stabilize your condition.
Treat injury.
Success. You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now.
Okay. Like I was saying, we're going to be doing a bit of a different playstyle than the last one. We just kind of maxed out our strength and smashed our way through. This time we're going to be doing a more force-focused option. So we actually got to pick a Jedi class at the start. And we had the choice between a Jedi Guardian, a Jedi Sentinel, and a Jedi Consular. So yes, I know it's the medical room. Shut up. So this time we went with the Jedi Consular. So.
For accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift controls to go up.
Mines? Why would I need mines?
This is the garage.
Great, open the door. Garage access. Garage is depressurizing, only in the garage door if you close the outer garage door and vice versa. You'll need two droids. I don't have two droids. Engine room? Is locked. Okay. Oh, hey, look, there's the second droid. Field survival pistol. Okay. What the?
Sensor droids emerged from this box when you opened it. These droids will make for excellent target practice. Use the weapon from this container to attack the droids.
Is this really the best time to be doing this? I must say I'm loving this larger inventory screen, because instead of having that small ass little box in the middle. Droid shock arm. What is config 1, config 2? Well, let's equip our pistol. Looks like we got the same general thing, just spruced up a little bit. Yes, it's equipped. Left click, right. Controlled by your statistics, behind the scenes calcs. Alright, yeah, remember, yes, great. Do it.
Change your target by pressing Q or T to left click on the object you want to attack. To attack an enemy, left click on the sword icon or press 1.
Yes, computer, I've already done it. Nope. I think we're good. We got some,
The impact armor from this locker can be equipped on the equip screen. To open the equip screen,
high security.
The blaster icon in the top right area. The lock on this container is too difficult to open. You'll need to use a security help open the
lock. Oh, really?
Look in the unlocked cylinder next to this one. If you encounter a difficult lock on a container...
Okay. That's cool that you can do that. That wasn't available in the first one. Components, parts, computer spike. Hey, computer spike. Alright. So let's see. I think we got some... Oh. There we go. That's where the armor is. We'll go ahead and equip that. Think we're good there. Alright, let's talk to this little buddy. Right, got it.
Some responses may influence how other characters react to you, so choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have, or how successful you are with those choices.
Okay.
3CFD is malfunctioning. You can fix it by using a part.
I got lots of parts.
You have already found one. If you repair 3CFD, he can join your party and assist you in repairing the ship.
Excellent.
Success. You have fixed 3CFD. Now he will join your party.
3DD. Sure. Beep boop bop. Alright, droids, let's go. Autobots roll out. Blast door. Okay. So. Hey, security tunnel this bitch. What? Alright, now I have my gun. Let's blast this thing open. Broken item.
Sometimes bashing or blowing open a container will break some of the items in the container. But you can use even broken items. They can be turned into useful components at a workbench.
You see, they didn't have that functionality in the first game. You know, it seemed like to me that bashing stuff open literally had no downside, but alright. Access security doors. Ah, close outer garage door. Open the inner garage door. Yeah. Security door status. Okay. All right. Where's that garage door? Is this it? No, no. Yeah. Magnetically sealed.
To access the area beyond this door, you will have to use solo mode default. Click the solo mode button at the bottom right area of the screen.
Is that that?
While in solo mode, move 3CFD to the security computer to open the door for you.
Yes, turn solo mode on.
This is the main hole.
Access security doors. Open out a garage door. Close in a garage door. Open out a garage door. Right, okay. And then we drive in here. Yes, it's the garage, I know, thank you. Security doors, close out a garage door. Open in a garage door. Yay! Oop, no, fuck. Open it. Okay. Log out. That's the outside of the ship right there. Okay. Seen better days there. There's
a
workbench.
With a workbench, you can break down objects in your inventory and
create components. Repair kits, weapons, armor. I can actually build stuff instead of just upgrading now. Nice.
Because of the damage to the Ebon Hawk, this workbench has limited functionality. You can still use it to create a repair kit, which you can use to repair yourself. Use the workbench to break down the items you've found into...
Right. Create or break down items. Ah, wow, this is... View breakdown items. Broken item. Break it down. Break it down now, y'all. Okay. Close. Oops. Use the workbench. I want a repair kit. So we create. And then use. Oh. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool. Alright, so that's where that blast door doesn't work no more. That's where we get off the ship. And there's no reason for that. Oh.
You may be able to override the door's locking mechanism from outside the ship. This is the starboard dormitory.
I was gonna say I'm kinda outside the ship as it is. Sparking wire, what's this?
These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism for the inner and outer garage doors. You can open and close the doors from here.
Why would I want that? Do nothing. Close inner garage door. Open outer garage door. Log out. Okay. Where was that? Yeah, here we go. Utility lift, yes. Lift controls. Go outside. Why are there mines on the outside of the ship? Man, Ebonhawk got fucked up. Hardcore.
Don't forget to explore the other side.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm exploring.
The bubbles ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically with your awareness skill.
And then the ones that I don't detect scare the shit out of me.
Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get too close.
Okay.
Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them. But you get to keep the mine, which you can then use to set as a trap for enemies or break down into components at a workbench.
Okay, recover it. Proton missile. I like how there's just a missile sticking out of the side of the ship there. That's safe.
Blow open
the engine room door. Jesus. Open hatch. Engine port. Alright, some parts. Okay. What's this?
This open hatch has some parts that will be useful for getting main power restored.
More parts. I feel like I'm swimming in parts. Exposed wiring.
These exposed wires control the door to the starboard.
Ah, nice. Okay. Override it.
Success. The door is opened.
Alright. Guess I'll have to go back into the garage and... Wait, what's that? Oh, it's just that. I already took that. Well, I think we're done on the outside of the ship.
You can use this...
Yes, I know. I can use it to go up and down. Whoops. I thought I said... Yes, shut up. Go inside. Man, this freaking computer announcer is very chatty. Alright, so let's do solo mode. Where's the garage? That's the garage. Come over here and you're gonna work the doors. You're gonna close the outer garage door. Then you're gonna open the inner garage door. And then all of my hopes and dreams are going to... come true. Yes, I know it's the garage. Thank you. So what's in here?
This is the starboard dormitory.
Just a couple foot lockers. Oh, maybe some good. Bunch of parts. Droid flamethrower.
Found a droid flamethrower. This is one of the special weapons the droids can use. To equip it,
open the equip. Yeah, I know how to equip stuff. All right, so we got a flamethrower. That is not the way out of here. There we go. I know it's the garage. Thank you. Close the inner. Open the outer. And we're good. All right. So let's turn solo mode off. Where are you? There you are. Now, yeah, main hold. Thank you. Now we're supposed to blow open this door.
This is the engine room.
Yes, thank you. Use the damn mine.
This is the engine room.
Okay. Port engine.
The port engine is shut down, but appears intact. Fixing the hyperdrive will allow you to restore power to the port engine and bring primary power online.
Yeah, that engine looks pretty busted.
The hyperdrive is suffering badly. You won't be able to make the jump to light speed until it is fully repaired, and you do not have the needed equipment here on the Ebon Hawk. However, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive to restore primary power and bring the port engine online. This will allow you to dock with the Paragus mining station for full repairs.
Alright, rig the hyperdrive.
Success! The hyperdrive is online. Primary power is restored. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel to Paragus.
Okay, I can do that. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, that's just gonna say it's damage. I don't need to hear the damn computer anymore. Yes, main hold. I know.
This is the cockpit.
Cockpit.
You can now
All right.
plot course to the Paragus mining station. To dock with Paragus, left click on the Paragus planet to select it, and then left click on the travel button.
Paragus to travel. Don't mind the gaping hole in the back of my ship. I really do wonder what the heck happened that it would be beat to hell.
The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone or something else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
Oh, that's not. Oh. Is that HK-47? No, it's silver. Did he get a new paint job? I've never heard of a silver HK. Eh, he's murdering somebody. Oh, is he killing those droids? Shit. Alright. I don't know if that's HK-47 or not, but perhaps a close relative of him? Certainly looked like it was the same build style, just silver instead of copper. It's a shame he wasn't more useful in the other game. Because I love his, like, how his character is written, just his voice and snide comments and whatnot. I wonder if we'll be able to get him in this game too. Probably not. I think Revan is, well, I don't know. Man, did they add that in the new game, or like was that in the original one? So that's pretty detailed. Again, I'm already pretty impressed with how everything looks, considering this was a 2004, I think? 2004, 2005 game? Yeah, like, that's great. All this stuff on the floor there. This thing on the wall. Yeah, you guys look kind of dead. It's my Calto tank. Calto tank, do you want to heal yourself? Nah, I'm good. Be cool when stuff like that is one day a reality in the real world. You know, it's like, oh, you got a, I don't know, some ailment? Here, just go take a nap in this vat of stuff that magically heals you. So yeah, it sounds like I can go back there and heal myself when I need to. Okay. Morgue. So you got a busted door here. Any door that can be bashed open can be cut through more easily with a lightsaber or construction tool. To bash open this door, equip a plasma torch on the equip screen and select bash on the first box of the action menu. Yeah, I doubt I'll be bashing that open with my fists. Org. Locked. Okay. Hopefully that's not locked. Alright, good, it's not. Medical bay container. I love me some loots. Some med packs, those are always useful. Nothing there. Is that a workbench? How about this? Medical storage. Locked. Well, yeah, you happen to have a computer here. Medical logs. Access log 253-12.
Still examining the survivors of the damage.
No, that's neat.
Looks like it goes by the name of the Ebon Hawk. Only one survivor, placed in the Koltal tank for recovery. The carbon scoring on the vessel suggests it was in a battle, but no indication of who fired on it. Couldn't get much from the Nava computer. I'm surprised the ship was able to make it inside the Paragus asteroid field without the asteroid drift charts. Aside from the lone survivor, we recovered an old woman. No life signs. There was also a protocol droid and a utility droid on board. Sent both down to maintenance while security sorts through the other items on the ship. It looks like the utility droid, a T3 unit, was able to get the ship working enough to get to the colony. We're prepared to...
Yeah, you think that's a, God, why can't I think of the word? They literally just said it. Oh my god, I'm having a freaking brain fart right now. Protocol droid, that's what it is. Yeah, you'd think that that's a protocol droid, but I'm willing to bet that, it's a bit more than a protocol droid. If it's anything like HK-47. Alright, access log 253.
Jedi, but we won't know for sure until we get the transmission back from the Republic. If the survivor is a Jedi, that would account for the recovery rate. But I'm more concerned that a Jedi here may cause trouble. Some of the miners, especially Korta, are already another accident today. A detonation in the ventilation tunnels. If the lockdown measures hadn't activated, the whole facility would have been destroyed.
Oh, well, that's
got
lucky.
Got the entry to the Kolto tanks in time, but the rest had to go to the morgue. One of the wounded said a droid caused the accident, but we couldn't get any specifics.
A droid. Yeah, see? Gotta watch out for that HK series.
Miners about the Jedi. A number of the droids have been acting oddly, and not even memory wipes seem to be fixing the problem. There was a detonation in another one of the fuel vents the droids were working in. We deactivated several of them and moved them down to maintenance, but we're still treating the plasma burns. That cuts us down to almost half shifts, and with the droids malfunctioning, we may not make the Tilo shipment for this month. Fortunately, the detonation didn't cause a lockdown.
Warning, there has been a fuel detonation in the mining tunnels. Emergency lockdown commencing. All personnel report to quarters and prepare for emergency venting countermeasures.
No, if the ventilation systems are malfunctioning, evacuate the medical bay. Everyone evacuate.
Man, you got some shitty recording here. I don't know if you noticed it or not, but the holo recording of her was mouthing along to the computer, informing everybody about the lockdown stuff. I don't know why. All right. Patient life signs. Deceased, recovered, deceased, so I guess we recovered. Patient treatment. All subjects being treated for superior plasma burns. Last treatment request resulted in death for all subjects except patient number 3, who was reduced to minimal life signs. Treat injury. Check the last treatment request. A lethal dose of sedatives was administered to all of the tanks, including number 3. There is no record of who ordered the treatment. What the fuck? So, somebody tried to murder everybody, but we survived, because I guess we're a badass Jedi. Attempt to track the treatment request. What? Oh, whoops, I was misinterpreting computer use for computer spikes. Whoops. Medical bay functions. What about the camera? Okay, that's where you are. More camera. Oh, hey, that looks like the lady from the... unlock medical storage room. Unlock door to the morgue. Access medical inventory. Looks like a number of medical based items can be manufactured using the medical workbench next to the terminal. Cool. Log out. Okay, some XP. What do we got in here? Storage container. Chemicals. Yeah. Med pack. Okay. What can we make? I already know about that. Use the lab station. Antidote, retinal combat implant. Interesting. Okay. We got a corpse here. You have anything? Plasma torch. Oh, hey, that's how we can get through the... Okay, you're not dead. Wait, yes, no. I vaguely remember. I forget your name. Damn, it's been a long time since I've done this part.
Find what you're looking for amongst the dead.
Yeah, I heard as I float in the Calto tank.
Yes, I hoped as much. I slept here too long and could not awaken. It may be I reached out unconsciously, and your mind must have been a willing one. Or perhaps you have been trained for such things.
I wonder how long this is after, KOTOR 1. You looked dead when I came
close
in.
Close to death. Yes, closer than I'd like. You have the smell of the Calto tank about you. How do you feel?
Pretty good, I guess. Enough of the false concern. What do you want?
I am Kreia, and I am your rescuer, as you are mine. Tell me, do you recall what happened?
The Harbinger. I don't remember that. But apparently we were aboard a Republic ship, the Harbinger.
Your ship was attacked. You were the only survivor. A result of your Jedi training, no doubt.
Okay. So I guess we weren't originally on the Ebonhawk, and then this Kreia character swooped in with it and plucked us away, and then it got beat to shit. I am no longer a member of the Jedi Order. Yeah, I think we'll go with that. So we are going to be once again going the dark side route, as always.
Your stance, your walk tells me you are a Jedi. Your walk is heavy. You carry something that weighs you down.
Yeah, we have a troubled history.
So it would seem. Keep your past and let us focus on the now.
Alright. How do we get here?
I do not know. I was removed from the events of the world as I slept. A survey of the surroundings may provide the answers we seek. The ship we arrived in must still be in this place. We should recover it and leave.
Hopefully it got, fixed. Why do you think we're together in this?
Once, and I fear our attackers will not give up the hunt so easily. Without transport, weapons, and information, they will find us easy prey indeed.
You seem nervous, worried. Is something wrong?
Even as I slept, I felt much unrest here. I saw strange visions, minds colored with fear. Now, everything here feels terribly silent. I would find out as much as you can about this place quickly. I fear we will need to depart as suddenly as we arrived.
Alright. Let's go look for a ship and some
to
weapons.
Extend yourself to some clothes. If only for proper first impressions.
Ha! Nah. Persuade, intimidate. We'll just do regular persuade.
I do not know. Why did they spare you?
They didn't. I got the same dose but survived.
Oh, indeed. A Jedi trance could protect one from such poisons. In fact, the sedatives may have been intended to keep you unconscious for some time. It would prove lethal to those untrained in such techniques, however. Most curious.
Interesting. Just get out of my way around the plectic course. You seem to know a lot about Jedi techniques.
Perhaps we could discuss it at length later on. Now we have other concerns, among them finding our new enemy.
Okay, just stay out of my way, I'll end up like these corpses.
I leave you to the explorations of this place.
Starting here, down the dark path. Nice. Yeah, this game actually has a Ah, it has a sound effect that plays whenever you get dark side points, too. Yeah, so they, plus a visual effect. Take your first steps down the path to the dark side. Self-serving acts and cruel responses to others will drive you further to the dark side of the Force, corrupting you and your appearance as you grow in power. Charitable and heroic actions will reverse this, bring you closer to the light side. Screw the charitable and the heroic. Give me that dark side. Pleasantly neutral. We got the, That's right. I moved it down here. The plasma torch. Bash this bad boy open.
Emergency lockdown. Overridden.
Aggressively overridden, I'd say. But I think we're gonna have to call it an episode here. We've already run for quite a while, thanks in part to that prologue. So thank you all for watching and checking out the new series, and we will see you when we return with more Knights of the Old Republic 2.